Hi, in this video, I'd like to show you how to use an HDRI sky as a background for your rendering using iRender Next. I'll show you how to select and load an HDRI image, set the rotation of the image, and use the Layers Wizard to position the background more precisely. Our goal is to create a rendering like this, where the HDRI image is visible as a background. To do this, I start in SketchUp with a model of a food cart kiosk that I downloaded from the 3D warehouse. To it, I've added a gazing ball and a deck chair. If I render this model without using an HDRI sky, I get this result. This is the rendering with just the automatic sky as a background. To add the HDRI sky, I go back to SketchUp and load our options dialog and select the HDRI sky tab. I can either select one of the pictured HDRI skies that are shown on the dialog, or I can load one from the disk. To load one from the disk, click on the button with the three dots to the right of the current HDRI name. I'm selecting an HDRI file that I downloaded from a website called openfootage.net. To preview the image after loading it, click on the magnifying glass button next to the plus sign. This is a 360-degree panoramic image of a beach in Italy. We can use the rotation slider control to pan the image until we see the portion of it that we want to use. We can also use the layer wizard to position the image more precisely. To load the Layer Wizard, click on the Layer Wizard button. In the Layers Wizard, we get a preview of what the background will look like behind the model. We can click and drag with the left mouse button to reposition the background. Once the background is positioned properly, just click the green render button to see the result. And here's the result. Notice that we now see the part of the HDRI image that we selected as the background, and that the rest of the HDRI image is properly reflected in the gazing ball. In this video, we covered selecting and loading an HDRI image, setting the rotation of the image, and using the Layers Wizard to position the background more precisely. To learn more about using HDRIs and other aspects of iRender Next, visit the RenderPlus website and check out our other videos and tutorials. Thank you.